Rollup at this subtotal is a summarize column modifier that lets you compute subtotals. You will obtain in the query more rows in identifying the totals and also more columns, one column that identifies whether the given row is a subtotal or not. By using different rollup subtotals or different options, you can obtain a lot of different kinds of subtotals. Let's see that with some examples. In this first example, I'm grouping by calendar year, but I embed it in rollup at the subtotal. Therefore, I'm requesting also the subtotal at the year level, and I want to identify the additional rows with a column year total that contains true if the given row is a subtotal. You see the result contains 2008 and 2009 as requested, but also a row containing a blank at the year that has true for the year total. And this is the total at the year level of all the amounts. You can specify multiple rollup is subtotal in the same query, and in that case you obtain all the combinations of the subtotals. In this case, I'm using calendar year and customer education with two new columns, year total and education total. You see that the result contains the normal values plus an additional row 2008 with no education. This is the subtotal at the education level. Then I have the same for 2009. But then I have additional rows that contain a blank in the year and a value for the education. This is the year total for the given education. And finally, I have an additional row containing blanks everywhere. That is the subtotal at the year and at the education level. So you have all the combinations of subtotal in the same query. If you want to reduce the number of subtotals, you can group the columns in the same rollup subtotal. Here I'm using rollup subtotal with the year and the education. And as you see, the result contains the subtotal at the education level, the subtotal at education level again for 2009, and only one row that contains the grand total. The order is important. Indeed, I have specified a hierarchy that contains year and education. But if you exchange the order and you provide first education and then year, you see that the subtotals generated are different. Now I have the year subtotal with the education, the year subtotal with the education, and finally the grand total of everything. So depending on the number of columns that you provide in rollup subtotal and their order, you get different subtotals. You can further reduce the number of subtotals generated by using rollup group. Rollup group lets you treat a set of columns as if they were a single group. And you see that if I use rollup subtotal again over year and customer education, but this time treated as a group, I no longer have the partial subtotal. I only have the grand total that contains no value for the year, no value for the education, and the complete total.